In this video, I'm going to share with you some of the work that I've been doing with my clients using Microsoft Power BI with Sage 50 to help them analyze their customer receivables better, drive down debtor days, and improve cash flow. If you want to start analyzing your Sage 50 data from a customer receivables point of view, I think there are three angles you want to look at your data from. The first is a summary big picture of where you stand now. How much customers owe you, who your big debtors are, and how much cash you might expect to receive this month. But just taking a look at this snapshot is not enough. Your position may be good, it may be bad. The next angle I think you want to look at your data from is that of trends. Are you getting better or are you getting worse? And then finally, if you actually want to do something this week to help drive down your debtor days, you need to get right down into the detail. So you need a detail view showing your customers and the invoices that you need to collect from. Let's take a look at my model and see. Firstly, the big picture view. Who owes me money? How much? And how much am I expecting to get paid this month? In the top left-hand corner, we can see the traditional view, the 30, 60, 90, 90-plus day view. And here we can see we have a mix of within due and overdue invoices, less than 30 days, 30 to 60, 60 to 90, and 90-plus. And we can see that we have a mix. We have quite a considerable amount of invoices that are overdue and a considerable amount that are still within due. But if you want to see a little bit more detail, we take a look at the next chart, which is essentially the same thing, but just looking at the next 8 weeks. And again, we're looking at the mix of within due and overdue invoices. And one thing we can see straight away is that 3 and 4 weeks old, we've got quite a large amount of invoice value that is currently within due, but I would expect will fall overdue fairly soon. To look at the main numbers, we can see our total debtors are £673,000. We have unallocated credits of nearly £26,000, and I'll come on to that later. And we have an overdue balance for our customers of £277,000. That means 41% of our debt that's outstanding is currently overdue. And we have a day's sales outstanding figure, DSO, of 63 and a half days. That's an approximation of how long it's taking our customers to pay us. We can see that this month, we're expecting to collect about £335,000. This is an estimate based on the current outstanding book and on average how long it's taking each customer to pay us. And we can see that against that figure, so far this month, we've collected £125,000. Now, it's the 20th of July, and we might be beginning to get a little bit worried, but we also know that most of our customers do their payment runs at the end of the month. In the bottom left, we have a tree map of our customers with the size of each square representing the balance, and we've got the top 10 customers and the others grouped together. We can see straight away that three of our largest debtors have nearly all their debts overdue. We can drill down to see what the picture is like for our smaller debtors. And among our smaller debtors, what I can see is a slightly lower day sales outstanding figure, but I can see there's a mix. We've got a number of customers with very large overdue balances and a number of customers with within due balances and a number of customers in between. So what this tells me about the portfolio of debt is really I've got a mix and it's kind of all over the place. So it's not one debt all concentrated in one customer. There's quite a mix among the entire customer base. I can drill down, say, into one of our larger customers. I'll drill down into 3A Church Street Limited. And I can see actually, the unallocated credits figure has changed to £14,000. I can see the customer has a balance of £33,000. There's within due invoices of just under £20,000 and an overdue balance of £28,000. Now, you can see straight away that doesn't add up. The reason it doesn't add up is because of these £14,000 in unallocated credits. And we can see, actually, that this month we were expecting from this customer about £56,000, and so far we've received £14,000. And it's probably fairly safe to assume that this £14,000 we've received this month is the same as that unallocated credit figure. What this means is we've taken a receipt from the customer and we haven't allocated that receipt against any particular invoice. So that's a kind of summary position, and if I can summarize, what I think it's telling us is we've got quite considerable debt and it's not being collected particularly fast. Now, depending on what industry you are in, this may be an acceptable figure or not, but it's not particularly fast nonetheless. The next thing I would like to look at is what about the underlying trend? Although the figure is not that great, is it improving or getting worse? So let's take a look at the trends. In the top left, we have a chart showing days sales outstanding over the last 52 weeks. And the first thing that strikes you is actually there's a tremendous variation from 1 month to the next. We can see today we're sitting at a little over 60 days, but back in May we were hitting 100 days. So we can see that since May we've made some quite considerable improvements, so that may be cause for celebration. But we can see the underlying trend over the last year is up. So gradually our debtor days have been increasing rather than decreasing. Now that can be driven by increases in sales. A sudden sales increase this month will drive up our DSO figure. So if we look at the chart in the bottom left, the 52 weeks gross sales running total, what this is the annualized gross sales invoice value plotted over the last year. And what we can see is steady growth, steady sales growth. That's good, that's great, the business is expanding. No sudden spikes, no sudden troughs, and good steady growth. In a situation with good steady growth, you might expect a slightly higher than normal DSO figure, because each month you're issuing a slightly larger invoice value. What we can see that there are no big spikes or troughs in this, yet we have big spikes and troughs in the DSO, which implies that we've got a very erratic collections process or payment behavior by our customers. If we want to look at more recent times, let's take a look at the charts on the right, which look at the last 91 days. On the top right, we look at the total debtors over the last 91 days. And that looks good. We've got a good decrease from nearly a million in debtors in May, which probably corresponds to that DSO of nearly 100, down to between nearly 700,000 now. So we've reduced our debtors between May and now by about £300,000, which is great. And you can see the trend line is down. Or is it great? Because actually, if we look at the bottom right-hand corner chart, I've looked at the 91-day running total sales, and that trend is down also. So if your sales are falling, you'd also expect your debtors to come down as well. So in summary, my trends are a little bit disturbing. They're not really giving me cause for celebration. I can see over the last year, although my sales are increasing, I've seen a steady increase in my trend in DSO, and I've seen great variations in the DSO figure, even though my sales figure hasn't been fluctuating that much. This is a strong indication to me that I really want to tighten up my debtor management. So let's take a look at the detail level and how we might actually start tackling that from a customer and invoice point of view. So here I've got a third tab in my model. In the bottom left, we can see the unallocated credits that are outstanding to be processed. And really to neaten up all of this, it would be very helpful if we went into Sage and actually allocated those credits against the customers. In the bottom right, we see all the outstanding sales invoices. So now on the same page, we've got the list of customers and we've also got the list of invoices. And then the two charts on the top right are showing the near time invoice value that was due and receipt value that was estimated to arrive. If we click on week zero, which is this week, it tells me that £98,000 worth of invoices fell due this week. And if I click on that bar, that filters the entire page of the report to invoices that mature this week and become due, and the customers that those invoices are for. That straightaway gives me a list of customers to target whose invoices fall due this week. Similarly, I can see that £19,000 worth of invoices fall due next week, and I can click on that in just the same manner, and I can see the customers and the invoices that make up that £19,000. But just because they fall due in a particular week doesn't mean we're going to get the money in that particular week, as you well know. If I click on due this week, I see that £98,000 worth of invoices were due this week. But actually, we're estimating £34,000 of that should have come in last week, £24,000 will come in this week, nothing next week, £14,000 the week after, and £22,000 the week after that. And I haven't added up the totals, maybe there's more the week after that, and so on. This calculation of the estimated week is done taking the invoice date and adding to that invoice date the average time it takes for that customer to pay. So just as we can click on due week or estimated week, we can also click on a particular customer. And if I choose again that customer that we were looking at before, 3A Church Street, what we can see is that Again, there's unallocated credits for the customer of £14,000, so we need to discount that against the total outstanding value of the invoices. We can see that the outstanding value of the invoices are £48,000. We take off the £14,000, which gives us the customer balance. And at the moment, we can see that there's, of those invoices, £19,000 are within due and £28,000 are overdue. As we saw on the earlier chart, we did receive that £14,000 this week. So that £28,000 figure of overdue is probably about £14,000 now. And we can also see, in terms of the week estimated, we were expecting to collect that £28,000 last week, but we didn't. What we actually did was we collected that £14,000 of that £28,000 this week. And we can also see of the remaining balance, we don't expect to collect anything in the next 3 weeks. That doesn't mean we can't, and it doesn't mean we shouldn't try, but what it does mean on past customer behavior, we don't exactly expect it. So that's a brief overview of the model that I've built for my clients to help them drive down debtor days and improve cash flow. Don't just take my word for it. Take a look at what my customer John has to say. And if you would like to join John as part of my merry band of very happy customers, of course, you'd be more than welcome to do so, and I can get you set up really quickly.